This morning we are outside, actually, not in the Rhode Show kitchen. We are on the fresh truck. It's all part of the CVS Health Charity Classic this weekend. We are going to make guacamole today. This truck is going to be one of the trucks that is going to be appearing at the CVS Health Gulf Classic as well, right?
Absolutely. We're looking forward to it.
Looking forward to it. Okay, so today we're going to make guacamole. Now, people say, okay, I can make guacamole at home, but you need fresh ingredients, and that's what this fresh truck is all about.
Absolutely. Fresh truck's all about wholesome, about nutrition, about food literacy, and about using the best of the best with ingredients. So a lot of people make guacamole at home, but they're not using the best of the best. And actually, our recipe is super simple because fresh ingredients will stand on their own.
Look, you make guacamole. Guacamole is such a great thing to have. It's really healthy for you. So a lot of people will just eat the guacamole as it is. That's what you're going to show us how to do today.
Absolutely. So we're going to do what we call the fresh truck easiest guacamole. So anyone can do this at home. Right. So just limited ingredients.
Yeah, so what do we need for this?
Well, we got our fresh avocados, of course. We got a little bit of citrus with some limes. We're going to use some onions, some tomatoes, and then some absolutely vibrant cilantro.
I mean, just look at everything that you have out here. It looks so, so beautiful, everything that you have here. And then we're going to go over what to look for when you actually look for an avocado.
Absolutely. We'll go over that. Do we want to go over it now?
No, just a little bit. Just a little bit. We'll keep them waiting for a little
bit. All right, yeah, we'll keep them in suspense for a little bit.
Keep them in suspense for a little more. All right, so we've got the ingredients. We've got the fresh truck here. We're going to go over this. We're going to make guacamole. Back to you.
For now, we want to head back outside. Will is in the CVS fresh truck.
That's right. Hey, you know what? This is a great gig today because this truck smells so, so good with all of the fresh ingredients on here. We are here with Chef Travis T-Bone on here. First of all, I love the name.
Yeah, that's what happens when you grow up with a cowboy family.
That's all right. We got guacamole. That's what's on the menu today. It's all part of the CVS Health Charity Classic this weekend because they are so focused on making sure that people eat the right way, eat healthy stuff, and that's what we're going to make today.
Absolutely. So one of the reasons we went with the guacamole is it's something anyone can prepare at home, even for kids, and it's a very nutrient-dense dish. So you've got everything from vitamins, you've got your essential minerals, you've got vitamin C. This is a natural antioxidant. So it's good for you. It's very, like I said, very vitamin-rich and very dense and healthy.
A lot of people, when they go into a market, they're looking for the avocados. We see the commercials all the time. What do you need to look for in an avocado? How do you check to make sure that it's ripe enough for you to make guacamole like
this? Well, this is the thing. You don't want it too ripe and you don't want it underripe. So you want to give it a little bit of push at the bottom, and just a little gentle push. If it gives a little bit, it's probably ready to go. Also, there's a button at the bottom. If you poke the button out, it should be a little bit green. If you get them where they don't have the button, it's oxidizing right away.
So they really do go quick. Should they be put in the fridge? Should you leave them on the counter? What's the deal with this?
It depends how ripe they are. But I would leave them on the counter, and if they're underripe, you put them in a paper bag at room temperature. Within a day or two, they'll actually get ripe the way you want them.
That's good info. Okay, so now I'm looking at the avocados you have here, and if you can see this at home, you are making little slices in that. Is that just easier for way to get
right,
all of that?
Yeah, it's less mess. And so if all of a sudden, you don't get your hands off.
We don't want to make a mess.
So if you score them up inside the actual shell, and then take a spoon, and you just kind of pull them out. And that way, you're not doing all the cutting on the board. I don't like to get too messy when I cook, believe it or not. So, and then you can see we actually went with a very chunky kind of format, and then we're going to mush it up a little bit. But I like a chunkier salsa or chunkier avocado.
I do as well. One of the great things about this, people see this, you can add guacamole to anything. It's really a healthy dish, has all of the good fats in it as well.
Definitely with the high in the fats, good fats. The other nice thing about guacamole is you can add anything to it. So we went as basic as possible, very pedestrian, very commonplace. But you get people to add garlic, and they'll add all different kinds of herbs and stuff. So, and you can get it as thick as you want, as thin as you want. It's a very flexible dish.
Sounds good to me. We can't wait to try it out. We'll talk about the fresh truck, everything that goes on, where you can see them this weekend. Back to you.
We are back out live at the fresh truck. It's finally my turn to be in here. It smells so good because there's so many fresh products. So kind of walk through with me and check out what they have. Strawberries, peaches, bananas, pineapples, oranges, mangoes, peppers, sweet potatoes, corn on the cob. We've got fresh lettuce. We've got cucumbers, onions, carrots, tomatoes. Whew. My goodness, I feel with the apron and everything, I can like work in a deli right now. I'm going to pass it off to Will, though, because he's been busy making guacamole, which I love.
That's right. We're here with Chef T-Bone. He's out here. Josh is over there. Wave to everybody. You're walking around
in the
back. We've got the guacamole. Now, you've got most of this prepared already. Tell everybody what you've done so far.
Well, we obviously did a fine chop on the cilantro. Mm-hmm. And that's one of the dishes, or one of the items of herbs that people actually sometimes overdo it. It's very overpowering, and it has a big finish at the end. We chopped up some tomatoes. We like the tomatoes once again because of the nutritional content, also to add some color and for texture. You want a little bit of citrus in there, and also the lime, when you put it in with the avocado, it prevents it from browning. And then we've got some finely diced onions once again, just for some punch. You don't want to overdo it with the onions. Salt and pepper and some blue corn tortilla chips.
Yum. Blue corn tortilla chips. I love those. I think it's, you also made this chunky too. You didn't really mush it up too much.
I like it chunky, and I also like them just a little bit before they're too ripe. But also, I have friends of mine, when I make it for them, they want it nice and creamy and almost a dip, because avocado actually is an old Aztec term that means avocado sauce.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that. I didn't know that. All right, talk to
me
us about...
Me neither. I just thought it meant delicious.
Yeah, well, it is delicious.
It's anonymous, yeah.
Tell us about, you guys are a part of the golf this weekend, which is big. Mm-hmm. Come on, Jess. Come on.
We are. I'm going to eat.
Go for it. Yeah, don't be shy. We're always welcome to eat on Fresh Hook. So, yeah, we're going to be part of the CVS Health Charity Classic on Sunday, you know, supporting their renewed commitment to health and wellness. We're going to be setting up shop there with our full market. We're going to have probably twice as much food as you see here. We're going to be giving away 150 tote bags with this recipe kit prepared for the first 150 people that visit us. And then T-Bone is going to be with us on the day doing cooking demos throughout the day. So everybody should definitely check in to see what we have going on, taste some good food, and then, you know, definitely shop with us.
It was great. Can I just say, did you shop with a little pepper, too?
A little bit of pepper, a little bit of sea salt.
So good. So good.
And I think sea salt really has, you know, you can put regular salt in there, but when you put sea salt in
there.
No, regular salt. A little bit of sea salt.
It really adds a lot of extra flavor to it.
And actually also, the sea salt itself, supposed the iodized table salt, has some trace minerals that are good for your health.
Okay, so we can load up on the extra salt?
I would still take it. Everything in moderation.
Where can this truck be found? I know this weekend you're going to be out of golf. Are you guys all over the place all the time?
We are all over the place all the time. We're going to be relaunching our weekly market program in Mattapan, Dorchester, East Boston, and Charlestown, so everybody can look forward to that. And then we're proud to announce that we're launching a mini version of Fresh Truck, which is going to be more events-driven, and we're looking at a statewide reach for that, too. So that's pretty
exciting.
Smaller
vegetables or still the same?
We're going to do a
smaller scale.
Always big vegetables. No, we're going to be doing a mini version of Fresh Truck focused on nutrition, education, and community outreach, and that's really going to be able to extend our reach beyond Boston.
And you were saying, you know, giving community outreach. I think it's so important because, obviously, you can go to the market, you can get a lot of these vegetables, but some people don't have access. I know it may sound crazy, but access to fresh stuff like you guys have. So having a truck pull up like this is great.
Absolutely. And I mean, that's our whole social mission and why we got started in the first place. Our objective is to improve food access and community health around Boston. And a big part of that, too, is just educating families around why it's important to eat healthy and how to prepare different kinds of healthy food. So Travis is one of our important partners.
Let's dig into this guacamole because I've been
watching. You got some right there.
Okay. Yeah. All right. I'm going to load this up. We got it right here.
And give it a big crunch.
I'm going to hand this to you.
Yeah. I got to talk now. He's got to chew. If you want this recipe, which you do because it's delicious, head on over to roadshow.com.